A leading epidemiologist says the numbers in Victoria are now so low that the government could reopen the state earlier. Christine Ahern leads our coverage this morning. Chris, good morning to you. What's the likelihood of this happening?
Carl, the Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews says he is staying the course and he only wants to do what is safe for Victorians. But one of our top epidemiologists, Professor Catherine Bennett, says we are smashing our targets and we could be in a position where the government could use the its own metrics they set to open up earlier. Certainly it depends on the numbers. We had 11 new daily infections yesterday and all eyes are on the numbers today. They should be released in the next hour or so. Despite the harsh lockdown and, of course, the bungled hotel quarantine. Somewhat surprisingly, the latest news poll in The Australian shows that 62% of Victorians believe that Daniel Andrews has handled the crisis well. This is despite the hotel quarantine inquiry basically reaching farcical levels with Victoria's top public servant and Daniel Andrews' right-hand man, Chris Eccles, being the latest person to say they simply can't recall who ordered security guards to man our hotels of return travellers. Not surprisingly, former Premier Jeff Kennett had something to say about that.
I'm surprised anyone knows we've got coronavirus down here. It is the most extraordinary situation. No politician has accepted any responsibility for any act that has occurred.
Things will get really interesting tomorrow at the inquiry because in the hot seat is Daniel Andrews.
Christine, thank you.
There is a COVID health alert this morning for Sydney Southwest after an infected person visited the Moorebank Sports Club on Monday, September 14. The club has been deep cleaned. Anyone who was at the venue on that day is urged to get a test. Leading doctors have joined the Prime Minister in loudening calls for borders across the country to reopen. Kerry Yaxley joins us with more. And Kerry, many doctors now agree these border bans are being politically driven.
Yeah, some have questioned the value from a health perspective of closing the borders. Infectious diseases expert Professor Peter Collignon has told the Australian Financial Review that some states are clearly going for an elimination strategy, which he says isn't really sustainable over the long term. We've had 16 cases across the nation yesterday, 4 in New South Wales. That has raised hopes that the borders will open up soon or could open up soon. Here is what Professor Catherine Bennett from Deakin University had to say. She's an epidemiologist.
I think being set up for that, allowing us to close down those last clusters with the borders open is all should be doable from an epidemiological perspective. So I think that's something we should prepare for.
South Australian health authorities could agree to open the border to New South Wales within days. The Premier does, Ali, have some concerns about that case of the Sydney taxi driver who may have been infectious while he worked for around 9 days.
Thanks, Kerry.
To breaking news in Victoria now, huge plumes of black smoke from a tip fire northwest of Melbourne Airport has prompted a smoke warning. Nine's Lana Murphy is there for us. Lana, good morning. Residents are being told to shut their windows and doors.
Well, Alex, this fire is really impacting the air quality and everyone who lives within just a few kilometres of Sunbury Road here in Buller is being encouraged to stay indoors and turn off their air conditioning or heating units if they are sensitive to smoke. Now, this fire, it broke out at about 6:15 this morning on a rubbish pile at the tip here along Sunbury Road. There's currently about 13 fire trucks responding and it does look like in the last few minutes the fires here have really managed to get it under control. The plumes have kind of dissipated in the air, but the air quality is still, of course, impacted. What we know is that this tip was shut down by the EPA in 2018 because there was exposed asbestos and litter outside the boundaries. In 2019, that licence was granted back to them. But now, of course, Alex, there will be a lot of questions that have to be answered.
All right, Lana, thank you for that. Also breaking right now in Victoria, air paramedics have landed on the Princes Freeway west of Melbourne, where there has been a serious car crash. There are severe traffic delays heading to Geelong with all lanes closed. Drivers are advised to avoid that area.